Okay, I'm pretty sure I got the same point here. From the last time that I was out here. So we can see some life starting to be reborn. There's a lot of leaves right here, otherwise it would be more green right now. But yeah. There's a whole bunch of deer right before I got here to this place. I've been seeing a lot of larger groups of animals and just awarenesses, consciousnesses gathering. And then the natural fencing, as in all the little things that poke, the thorns, all the thorn bushes. And I remember whenever I was young, and it would be so, even into probably young adulthood, just being so, especially where I'm at, there's thorn bushes everywhere. But now I'm in a place where it's not like an annoyance, it's more, I'm seeing the design of it, that there's natural pathways that the forest, plants, and animals as well, they create, and to allow energy to flow, to also help guide animals and even people towards certain energetics and certain plants even, in nature. And that's also something I tell people whenever they're talking about building fences or even electrifying the fence because of all the critters that want to come in. And I'm like, look into living fences. I mean, if you're not able to see what nature does, how nature solves all the... there's no problems to solve, it's just... The design of it, how it flows, so you can work with the living matrix and flow with it, or you can, you know, stay caught up in the artificial matrix, the dead realms, you can call it, the concrete cities. Or you can utilize thorn bushes. You can utilize certain types of bushes to build living fences. Like all that. There's so many thorn bushes around here. I had to really weave around them, and you just learn how to flow instead of trying to push your way through. Or even seeing things as obstacles to push through. It's not, it's an opportunity to navigate it, to learn from it, to learn potentially something about yourself that you maybe were blocking or couldn't see before. Allow the natural world to remind you of your true nature. Not to say that any nature or way you decide to behave isn't necessarily untrue, because you're being true to something. It's just, what is that something? So it's a purpose, fully being purposeful in your choices, pure positioning. All right, I'm gonna try to soak up some sun. Peace. Boom. So the transformation of the natural world has made it a little bit more difficult for me to find certain marks that were there before, the previous seasonings of nature. But what I did find and wanted to share, it's just starting. Oh my gosh. This is Thor's mantle right here, beginning to grow. This is the third year. And yeah, it just keeps coming back. They get so big. Burdock. And this is one from either Ukraine or Russia. It's just out here in the woods. I usually try to feed it with my essence. I'll put my bare feet down. Ooh, here's some leeks. So, yeah, that's awesome. I'm gonna look around here now that I found my area. It's been transformed. See if there's anything else coming up. That's so awesome. imbalance. Focus. Sweet. So yeah, I wasn't expecting this. This is pretty cool. Ooh, this is so hard. Thank you. cardinal. That is the moon. Find a better view. Nope. Oh, yes. Right when it's coming up. This is pretty cool. Here at least she's coming up softly. There's a soft white, yellowy. And then when she gets up higher, oof. She's gonna ease us into it. It's gonna be some powerful reflections, inflections. So, yeah, flow with the process.